Now, let's look at the next algebraic operation, which is scalar multiplication. So let's look at what this operation is. So this is the second operation that we will see. We already saw addition and subtraction. I'm considering them as one subtopic. Coming to the next subtopic, that's your scalar multiplication. So how does this look like? So what you do is you take a matrix, and if you multiply it to a scalar, say this matrix is A, then what is lambda A is my question. What is lambda A? So one thing that you have to understand is, if your input data is a matrix, your output also will be a matrix of some form, right? Now, what I want to see is, if I multiply lambda to this matrix, how will this new matrix look like? So for example, for that, I'll simply do this. I'll take a matrix. I'll take a 2x2 matrix. If I multiply lambda to this, what will happen is, each and every element inside will individually get multiplied to lambda. That is what you mean by multiplying a scalar to a matrix. So this is what the answer is. So this will also be a 2x2 matrix, of course. But that's how it will look, right? That's how the operation will be. So it's extremely simple. Like, you pick up each and every element, multiply that to lambda, and put the result in the corresponding position, right? That's how it is. So as until now we have seen that addition, subtraction, and scalar multiplication. So I would just like to put a note here. Addition, subtraction, and this third operation, or basically the second operation as far as my lecture flow is concerned, scalar multiplication. These three. These operations hold, this is your note, they hold good all laws of basic algebra. So the algebra that you know, addition of two numbers, subtraction of two numbers, multiplication, all the laws that you know, they all hold good as far as these operations for a matrix is concerned. I'm not talking about matrix multiplication now. That's a different thing. We'll see that next. After scalar multiplication, we will see matrix multiplication. But as far as scalar multiplication is concerned, it's as simple as the basic algebra laws that you know, right? So I would like to post a question here, and it'll be good if you answer. That will actually complete this subtopic. So I'll take a 3x3 matrix now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And if I multiply a minus 2 to this, I would like to know what the answer will be. So this is a question mark that I would like to put. So as I already told you, you take the scalar, you take every corresponding element and multiply that corresponding element to the same scalar. So 1 into minus 2, it will be a minus 2. 2 into minus 2, it will be minus 4. Then it will be a minus 6. Then it will be a minus 8. Minus 10, minus 12, minus 14, minus 16, minus 18. And here you go. The output matrix also obviously has the same order, because just the corresponding elements have been taken up, they've been multiplied to something, and then they've been put back. The result has been put back in the same position. So the number of positions is obviously not going to change. It will be the same. And as you can see, it's extremely simple, and there's no other complication involved as far as this particular operation is concerned. So I think that completes scalar multiplication.